should never forget about how powerful this guy is. Anything that don't want to bat, you had to stay away from him regardless.
Yeah. Let's listen in. The Braves about to celebrate.
Do it, anyone.
I mean, we'll see if Brian Snicker gives a little speech. Looks like this is kind of the pre-celebration, Big Hurt. You know, just kind of getting ready. But Soler, popping on your point, he had two game-winning home runs. He won the game, right? Game four in Atlanta. He essentially wins this game's game winner. They win 7-0, a three-run home run. And then he led off the World Series with a home run. It's just so impressive. Look, we've talked about it, too, in that Brett Frank, Alex Anthopoulos, the general manager, and a team that wasn't playing great, but that had won 3 years in a row the division. That while our best player's hurt, and it's just not our year, he went out and made big-time trades, and all of them paid off.
Alex rolled the dice at the right time. Soler was struggling this year in Kansas City after two monster seasons. But the week that he got traded, he got hot. He had a two-home-run game. Next thing you know, he was traded to the Braves, and he hadn't stopped since. This guy's one of the strongest home-run hitters in all of baseball. I've seen it up close over the last few years. Not shocked that he hit the ball almost 600 feet. Yes, it was almost 600 feet tonight over the train track because this guy's a special home-run hitter. But being in Atlanta, you know, it excited him with a whole new bunch of characters that you can tell they're close. And I know the type of motivation they got in that clubhouse. We talk about Ron Washer. Snicker and Washer, they're a great combination. Both been managers. They did a hell of a job of motivating these guys to continue to play hard every day.
Frank, I agree with everything you said. I still have a hard time with the 600 feet.
600 feet. It hadn't landed yet. It went across that train track.
That ball haven't landed.
And it really cleared it. It was...
Kevin, I cast it 446. Frank cast it 600.
600.
I go 700.
Here's the thing.
It was a bomb.
When something happens that's never happened in the history of the game, I love that. And what happened with the NLCS... MVP and the World Series, first time that these two guys were not on the roster at the beginning of the year. They got acquired and both of them MVP. You can't say enough about the way they fell, but more importantly, the way they stood up.
Yeah, it's a good point. And it's only the third time ever the World Series MVP has been acquired at some point in the middle of the season. But it just speaks to this Braves team. I mean, they got contributions from everywhere. We talked about the bullpen. The bullpen was a weakness for this team at one point during the year. So they completely turned that around. But let's go back to Fried. Bobby, you mentioned you want to get him here. Hopefully we get him to the set. But Charlie Morton goes out game one. That's their ace. Fried's kind of their 1A. Then tonight, Fried gets stepped on. I mean, look, we were worried that he broke his ankle or broke his leg in that first inning. He gets out of it and then was incredible tonight.
First fastball, 98 after that. The guy was...
Hold on, pop, just one sec. Let's see if Brian Snicker gives a little address and they start popping champagne here.
Hey, fellas, give me a break. Wait.
You go hold this, son of a bitch.
How's it going,
Snicker?
Hey,
cookie.
What are you doing?
Oh, no. Hey, this is going to be quick, fellas. I've been thinking about this.
Oh, my God. Oh, wow, you're sensitive.
You know what? The simplest thing I think I could put this. You know what, boys? You guys are going to be world champions for the rest of your lives.
Come on.
He forgot to put the goggle down. Tomato eyes tomorrow.
He didn't learn from you. I tell you.
Come on, man. You've been watching Poppy for a minute.
You heard Sticks. I think I need to pull these things down right now.
Oh, yeah. He stood there and took it, too. Hey, I thought what he said, a couple things he said were beautiful. Let's start with this one. You're world champions forever. You all are world champions forever, too. You feel that? Is he right, Al?
He's 100% right. And, you know, the big fella next to me has three. Frank has one. I have one. And growing up, I came up watching Dan Marino and Charles Barkley, and I know how much they regretted not winning a world championship. And then I saw John Elway. And when I look at John Elway and I look at Freeman, I'm so happy for Freddie Freeman, because as much as John Elway meant to the Broncos and Colorado, that's how much Freddie Freeman means to Atlanta. And I got to tell you, fellas, getting to know this team a little bit over the last 10 days, it's hard not to cheer for them. It's hard not to fall in love with them, from Swanson to Freeman to Snicker to Ron Washington. They're baseball lifers. They're not the analytic nerds, but they're baseball lifers that love baseball, play baseball, and they're world champions.
Yes, when you play professional sport, you definitely would love to win many championships. But the hard one is the first one, Kevin. The one that you will never forget. I can imagine how these guys feel in the clubhouse right now, just winning this one World Series. That one first one that you get out of the way, hopefully they got many coming, but this one is the most important one.
Well, this team, their core is incredible. They got a chance of being back in the same situation like we've seen in this Houston club. Their core is great. They keep Freddie. I don't know what they're going to do. They got so many players. Somebody's going to have to leave, because they got four or five guys starting that outfield. And they're going to have some questions that are going to be asked by spring training. But this team, they went out and won this thing, not 500 at the break. And to play the way they played this the second half and win a world championship with four new traded players to the team, it's an amazing feat. Duvall left there last year after an incredible year. Came back after the All-Star break. Was incredible. So I'm happy for the Braves. You know, I'm a Georgia boy, but I got to say it. And many years of heartbreak living in South Georgia without a championship, and watch these guys celebrate. Proud of them.
Well, I thought, and well said, Frank. I mean, you're right. Look, they've won the division four straight years. Obviously, the NLCS last couple of years, now they break through. But one other thing that Brian Snicker said, again, this, he's been in the organization for 45 years. And when the Braves last won in 1995, he was a coach, I think at A-ball, in the minors for Atlanta. Bobby Cox, of course, the manager, the great manager for all those years of all those excellent Atlanta teams that John Smoltz played for. And he said, can't wait to show this to Bobby. Bobby Cox is a legend. Bobby, I know you're home watching. And we're all happy for you, because, you know that Brian's going to take that to Bobby, who, you know, it's all... He was his mentor, Alex, you know? And so I'm sure he is just beaming seeing Brian Snicker being able to do it and take it home again.
It's an incredible story. It's a romance story of baseball, right? It's the epitome of loyalty, sticking with it, going against the current. And the Braves did it in a contrarian way. The days I thought we have managers, you have over 200 major league experience, professional baseball experience. And when you look at Albies and you talk about how much Ron Washington helped them, it's hard to quantify. You can't replace experience. There's no shortcut for experience. And good old baseball one, that makes me very happy.
I mean, he's a guy that I've been with our conversation for a long time. Of course, Bobby Cox, I saw how to do with the way he handled the business, the way he treat his player, the way he got things done. So I'm pretty sure Bobby is at home enjoying this like he's in a clubhouse.
This is great for this guy. He might be one of the last guys to ever do this. 40-something years in the organization. Baseball is so full of turnover nowadays. To be there for 40-something years and win as a winning manager in the World Series, it's an incredible feat. And especially after a year of losing the great Hank Aaron and also the great Phil Negro, who meant so much to this organization.
I thought that was awesome that Terry McGuirk, who was just there in that picture, who's the chairman, I thought that was so awesome that he said that on the podium, right? Like, that's what he ended with. And, you know, to above with Hank Aaron and Phil Negro looking down, you know that's a factor in this Atlanta Braves team. Freddie Freeman, he is Mr. Brave. We touched on the pregame show, Poppy, right? I mean, this is... You know, this is a guy, 11 years synonymous with Braves baseball for a long time. And you said the first one's always hard to get to. But, man, for him, that's pretty epic, right? He came up, they were a playoff team, and then they weren't so good for a while. And now they're world champs.
I remember Freddie when he first came to the big league, and we went to play in the league against the Bray. This kid wanna figure it out at the gate. He had a conversation. I'm pretty sure the way he had a conversation with me, he had a conversation with Frank, with A-Rod, with all the guys established at the big league, trying to have answer for those questions. And a smart player, that's how they go by the business. They want to learn, they want to figure it out. Now he's the leader in the clubhouse. Now he is the one who got all this young blood that tonight became to be world champion. He is the face of the franchise. When you think about Freddie Freeman, you think of Hank Aaron, Mr. Hank Aaron, rest in peace. You think about guys at that level that represent the organization very well.
Yeah, 5 home runs this postseason for Freddie Freeman. That ties an Atlanta postseason record. And a lot of contributors, obviously, on this team. Ian Anderson hit innings the other day. I mean, how about that?
Here he comes.
Well, it's funny. We were just talking about Freddie Freeman, and here he comes. There you go.
He is.
It's like we talk about him and we summon him. Congrats, man.
The doctor.
Oh, it's all good.
Let it get wet. Congratulations, buddy. You well deserve it, man.
It's your time.
It's your time.
Congratulations, bro. I'm so happy for you.
Unbelievable.
Got a chair right back.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, I'm going to take a load off. You know, you've been standing all night.
One of the quicker games, too.
I know. Well, I already talked to you up there, so you got, go ahead. You got, I'll give it a start here.
We were talking a little bit about how happy we are for the way you've done it. You've been there for 15 years. You know, you displayed incredible discipline. You've gone through a lot personally, but you stuck in there in the shy years, right? And you were the guy that bridged it. Is this more relief or more happiness?
More happiness. It's actually pretty incredible what this organization has done in such a short time. I mean, we've lost 97 games 6 years ago, and we're looking at 4 straight division titles and a world championship now. It's just a testament to this organization. The guys they brought in, the front office, they pushed all the right buttons, and we played so well for the last 3 months. It's since the trade deadline, we're the best team in baseball.
Mm-hmm.
And we played like that in postseason, and here we are, world champions. Just like you guys.
Buddy, I'm so proud of you. And being said, I watched you play the game since day one.
Mm-hmm.
And I watched you 15 years later. And this is the same guy that bring the same approach, the same discipline, the same dedication. I see all this young blood talking about you, how the kind of leader that you have become to be throughout the years. How you can keep up with all that?
I don't know. It's just that you guys know it's the drive, the fire to want to win this. And, you know, I came up in such a great organization. I had Billy Wagner, Chipper Jones, Tim Hudson, David Ross, Brian McCann. I had all those guys that I came up with, and they showed me what winning was like. And I came up when they were winning, and then I went through the hard years, and I knew what was instilled in me from those veteran guys that I had to take that and carry that over and bridge it. And I'm just so thankful that I was able to just take this home. Being in this organization means everything to me, and I cannot believe – I'm looking around and see it's 2021 World Series champions, Atlanta Braves.
Wow.
That is what it's all about right there.
But Freddie, I got to say this. I grew up an Atlanta Braves fan.
Yeah.
Since I was a puppy. Okay. I've watched your career, and I know what you mean to the city of Atlanta, but I got to ask, do you want to be here the rest of your career?
Of course. I know, of course. Everyone knows that answer.
Yes.
You know, did I think I was going to be sitting here with no contract? But everyone knows. This is a crazy game, crazy business, but everyone knows where my heart is, and
yes.
This is the Atlanta Braves. I've been here since I was 17 years old. Almost half my life I've been in this organization,
wow.
So I think everyone knows how my heart is in this organization. That means everything to put on that Braves uniform every day, so hopefully I can continue to do that.
So two-part question here. As you're running to first base to catch the final out,
yeah.
What are you thinking? And B, what did you do with the ball?
The ball I still have.
Oh, there it is.
It's yours, baby. It's yours.
I don't have it on me, but I hit it somewhere.
Lockbox.
I think I'm going to probably give it to Brian Snicker, and then whatever Brian wants to do with it, yeah. See, I'm not getting rid of that.
That's
one.
The way to go.
When I saw the ball hit on the ground, I knew it was going right to Dansby. I mean, everyone knows. You can see the trajectory of the ball. And then once I turned and he was throwing it to me, not going to second, I saw that ball coming to me. I said, oh, my gosh, we're world champions. And That was the coolest moment that you could... I mean, you guys know, it's like everything you work for, and it all of a sudden happens, you know? It's like after so long, and man, it's just... I don't even know how to feel, you know what I mean? Like, it's, you're just numb inside
right now. Don't worry. You're going to have plenty of time.
Take it all in. Oh my. You will be part of Atlanta soon. Don't worry.
We're going to let you go. Before we do, first of all, you're one of the classiest guys this league has ever had. We appreciate that. And love you for that. But before you go, just take a look at the monitor, the battery right now. What do you feel about what's going on there right now? Look at that scene. Say hello to everybody.
That's right now.
See, yeah,
right
give now. A wave. Say hello.
Oh, my gosh.
They're watching. There you
that
go.
That is so awesome.
They've been
unbelievable the last three games. I heard there's like 130,000 people there on Sunday between the game and the battery. So I know they wanted a championship just like we did for a long, long time. And we're able to bring it home.
You did.
Oh, my gosh.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hey, before you go... Yeah. I know you're a free agent,
And
this is what I do with the guys, with the monster that we came to be free agent. I baptize them.
Beta man!
Oh, shit!
I'm called a beta man!
Don't go to the supermarket with that money.
I like that.
There you go.
Congratulations, Freddie.
Well deserved.
Congrats, Freddie.
Thank you.
Take care, Freddie.
Good for you, man. Congrats.
There you go. So, Freddie, who knows about the World Series trophy? He'll remember Poppy spraying him with money.
There you go. And there it is. The Atlanta Braves are the champions. Fourth time in their history, first time in 26 years, and the celebration and the postgame show rolls on FS1.
Managing type 2 diabetes?